Welcome back to the program. We are going to switch gears here just a little bit as we welcome to the Minuteman Press guest line, Nick Novak, who is the Vice President of Marketing and Communications for Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, the state's kind of chamber of commerce, and thought it would be good to give you some information on prices, which we know are up, but there's a lot of stuff that you should consider before you point the finger of blame in certain places, I guess is what I would say. So good morning, Nick. Welcome to the program.
Good morning, Tim. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. So you are looking at something other or in addition to what we're all looking at, which is the inflation that's going on out there, which we know is running about 8% on an annual basis over last year, has been for the last couple of months. And we're annoyed by that. We all are. Everything's costing us more, and we probably didn't get that much of a pay raise in most cases. But before we go, melt down on the local restaurant owner or the local widget manufacturer or whoever it is, it's important to note that you look at something called the Producer Price Index, and maybe you can explain to us a little bit about that and how that affects the prices people are seeing on the shelves.
Certainly. Well, the inflation number that you just mentioned on the consumer side, that consumer price index you mentioned was roughly around 8%. That's kind of what all of us, when we go to the store, when we go out to eat, you know, those prices that we're seeing that are much higher than they used to be. That year over year in the month of May was 8.6% higher. Now, that is a 40-year high. As all of us know, inflation on the consumer side is just absolutely way higher than it needs to be and that it should be right now. And that's why we're seeing all of these higher costs. I mean, year over year on the consumer side, gasoline is up nearly 50%. Electricity cost is up over roughly 12%. Another big driver is natural gas, kind of those pipe utilities, up 30%. But what you mentioned is that it's not just consumers who are seeing this higher cost. It is the businesses who are also seeing higher costs, and it's actually even a little bit worse for businesses and producers when you look at the numbers that the federal government just released this past week. So that producer price index, this is what companies are paying for goods and services. So instead of what the final consumer is paying when they go to the store, when they fill up their tank of gas, the PPI measures what businesses and producers are paying. That is actually up nearly 11% year over year in the month of May. And this is concerning because if businesses are paying double-digit increases right now, that means that the inflation that consumers are seeing at 8.6% might not be the top of what we're going to see. You know, we might see that number creep up even more on the consumer side, because if businesses are paying those higher prices today, it means consumers will likely have to be paying those higher prices tomorrow.
It does, or else something gives in the middle, whether that's employees' wages or owners' wages or using cheaper, inferior ingredients, which, again, most companies are not going to bend to most of that pressure because, you know, they've developed a successful business model that the way things are going.
You're exactly right. And so, you know, no matter which way you look at it, these inflationary numbers, both on the consumer side and the producer side, are just bad news for everyone, because it means we're all paying higher prices. The business owners are paying higher prices, the consumers are paying higher prices, and it just means less money in all of our pockets, which is obviously bad news for the economy. Now, I will mention one of the things that is driving these higher costs, especially on the producer side, is energy. Everyone who goes to fill up their gas tank, they know how much higher gas prices are right now. I was in Illinois this weekend, and unfortunately, had to look at some of the gas prices there, and $5.59 is what it is just over the border. Luckily, we're not that high in Wisconsin, but even though it's painful for us to see these higher gas prices, manufacturers are thinking about what it costs for electricity and other energy that they consume, because manufacturers, which is the largest industry here in Wisconsin, they use roughly 30% of total U.S. energy consumption, and energy prices are driving this PPI increase at 10.8%. So if you look just at the month of May, just month over month from April to May, energy costs are up 5% nationally, and that accounts for about 70% of that increase that producers are seeing right now. So when we talk about these higher costs, it's really energy that is driving these higher costs. And unfortunately, a lot of that is due to the decisions the Biden administration is making, that is trying to curtail drilling permits, trying to prevent new pipelines, trying to make it just more expensive to use fossil fuels as they try to transition to more green energy.
And that's going to be a process that no matter whether you're for or against it, you know, kind of the changeover that the Biden administration has, you know, owned up to at least and said we're in a transition period. Okay. The idea that we're sort of hostages to that transition, I think, is something that a lot of people are, you know, maybe not thinking of it in that way, but if that were to be the case, and we're just going to say, look, we're going to sweat this out, and gas is going to be $5 a gallon or close to it for the next 2 or 3 years while that transition gets us to more of a majority of renewable fuels, that means that inflation stays where it is or possibly a little bit higher, not just for a couple of more months, but probably a couple of more years, doesn't it?
You're exactly right. I mean, if we continue down the path that President Biden wants to when it comes to his energy policies, we can be looking at these high prices for years. And that's honestly not sustainable for our economy. Inflation for a short time, you might be able to handle it, raise some prices, and hopefully get them back down. But when you're looking at these energy policies that President Biden is pushing, I mentioned some of those. I mean, just trying to have fewer drilling permits for oil and gas, trying to, you know, prevent new pipelines, canceling the Keystone XL pipeline. You know, he's looking into having the SEC actually have more regulations that relate to climate change and putting new gasoline standards on for automobiles. And all of this is a way to, as you said, transition to green energy like solar, like wind. But it's doing so at a much faster pace than is sustainable. We like to say that if he's doing this, you know, he's out on a bridge, but he's on the middle of the bridge while there's still light on the other side on fire, and it's not done yet. I mean, you need to, if you are going to do this transition, you need to do it over a long period of time and have a good plan in place. You can't just end something that all of us rely on in the manufacturing sector, as consumers, in every way of life, to make sure that we have this affordable, reliable energy. And so it's definitely something that is a big concern for the business community, and ultimately is going to be a big concern for consumers because they're going to continue to see these higher prices.
Let me ask you, Nick, how this might impact different sectors of the business economy, mostly from a size perspective. We're, you know, championing in many communities where, you know, shopping our local businesses and supporting our local businesses, and that's all great. But I kind of look at these numbers and I say, well, wait a minute, if it costs, you know, Ma and Pa Kettle, who, you know, have a antique store or something, maybe that's a bad example, but something that has a bunch of supplies coming in, grocery store, let's just say, and their delivery services and trucking services and energy costs to keep the coolers cool and all that kind of stuff are all up at this 10.8 or 11% level, they've likely already done everything they can to be as efficient as possible, and they're going to have to pass most of that on. It would seem to me that people, corporations that have, you know, billions of dollars in profits every year have a little wherewithal to say, well, okay, we can hold some things here, and it's going to create some disparity between what those end prices might be that's greater than the normal competition in the marketplace. Am I off base there?
I think if you look at what these higher costs are doing, whether you are a large multinational corporation or the mom and pop shop right down the street, this is going to have an impact, and I'll just paint a little bit of a picture here for you. No matter what type of business you are, you have to, you know, pay for different aspects of the supply chain and different products that you have. So if it is that mom and pop shop that you know sells groceries or whatever it is, you still have to pay for the trucker who is going to bring all of those groceries to your facility. Now, trucker wages are going up because there's a shortage of truckers here in the United States, just like there is in pretty much every industry. We have a severe workforce shortage, some of that driven by policies that are keeping people out of the workforce because they may feel they don't need to go back into the workforce yet. But no matter which way you look at it, there is a shortage. So we're seeing wages go up at a much faster rate, you know, for truckers and other folks within the supply chain. Now that trucker goes to fill up his vehicle with diesel fuel, and that is so much more expensive than it was a few months ago, a year ago, 2 years ago. So now those costs are going on to it. And so, you know, that mom and pop shop is going to be seeing those higher prices. If you look at a larger retail establishment that has locations all across the country, well, they're not just paying one trucker to bring things out. They have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of truckers all across the country that are now getting higher wages, that are paying more for gas. They're picking up products that cost more to make because the energy it uses to manufacture, because shipping costs are so much more. I mean, if you look at any part of business right now, no matter what size of company you are, these prices are going up. It's going to impact all of us. And honestly, even if you are a larger corporation, you're still going to see these, and you're still going to have to pass those costs on, because most companies reinvest those profits back into the business, back into their local communities. And so there are tight margins all across the board here, and it's really going to end up having higher prices for everyone. And unfortunately, like I said, a lot of this is being driven by bad public policy that is just exacerbating the issue with inflation. It's driving up demand. We've flooded the economy with more borrowed money that we don't have, while not having the ability to have the supply that is necessary to meet that demand. And that's where we see these higher costs. So we really need to get government spending back in check. We need to try and reinvigorate the workforce and get more people back into the workforce so we can increase that supply. And ultimately, that's going to be what brings these prices down.
Well, and it's a tricky business in doing it, and I know we've heard experts talk about the Fed's role in this, and everybody has a role in this to some degree, but what we're set up for right now is, of course, if you used to buy four widgets a month or whatever we're talking about from a product standpoint, and now that's up that much, you might only buy three. And that pushes back, all the way across industry, across manufacturing, across service industries. You only go out to a restaurant three times instead of four. Yeah. And pretty soon, the profits get cut into from both sides for a business. They're not getting quite as much revenue, perhaps, because even though their prices are increasing, the overall bottom line is staying the same. Now you got fewer customers, perhaps, or at least fewer purchases, because people don't have 10% more money than they had last year. This is the perfect scenario to plunge us into an ultimate recession, isn't it?
you're spot on there. And unfortunately, the Treasury Secretary this past week, President Biden this past week, have both been trying to say that a recession is not inevitable. We're able to get through this. We're going to be able to, you know, still grow the economy. And I don't know what data they're looking at that all of our members across Wisconsin are not seeing, but every business we talk to, so many of them are concerned about the state of the economy right now because this inflation, as I mentioned, is unsustainable. You're going to have people not able to buy as much as what they once were. You're going to have businesses who aren't able to buy as much as they once were. And this is all going to lead to a slowing economy and ultimately probably a recession. And so I think that we need to be prepared for that. You know, we definitely see something coming in the next year. I think if you ask most economists, they're going to say that a recession is probably likely in the next year. And unfortunately, the administration in Washington is not seeing that and are not trying to pursue policies to slow that or stop that. So it's definitely something we're paying attention to at WMC and trying to make sure that our members are prepared for this. But ultimately, these higher prices are going to be around for a while. And so I guess we're going to all have to get used to it as long as we continue to have President Biden pushing these policies that aren't good for the economy.
All right. Nick, appreciate you very much giving us some background on that. We've got open phones coming up on the other side. So thanks for your time this morning. And
thank you very much.
We'll lean on you from time to time. Nick Novak from WMC.